Just one day away from the one-year anniversary of that Catholic supply store rape and murder that happened in West County here in St. Louis. You can think back following that when Thomas Bruce was charged and is now behind bars. In that case, we learned of more incidents potentially happening down in Jefferson County. And now we're learning about another one. Potentially he's connected to another case down in Memphis, Tennessee, from about more than 30 years ago. Now, let's just take a step back to put this all into perspective. The family of Setley Alley, the man who had been executed in the murder of 19-year-old Marine Susan Collins, is hoping DNA could be what exonerates him, and they're asking a judge to order it. Alley had been executed in 2006 in Tennessee after spending decades on death row. Now, 30 years after the murder, authorities wonder if Thomas Bruce may be responsible for her murder. Collins and Bruce attended the same avionics course in Tennessee. Now, Collins was found murdered after she went missing following a run in 1985. The Innocence Project, a nonprofit legal organization, argued for a DNA test of that case's evidence, but were denied before Alley's execution. Now, the brutal nature of Collins' killing, the Catholic supply store crimes, and that Bruce link to both of them have raised doubts for the Alley's guilt in this particular case. Now, today in Tennessee, a judge will actually be making a decision on if DNA will be brought into this case down in Memphis, Tennessee, seeing if Thomas Bruce is potentially behind this murder. Of course, Fox 2 will keep a close eye on this and bring you the latest as more details in this become available. But for now, live in Clayton, Darion Henderson, Fox 2 News.